mean, if you are a Flyers fan, you're super excited. We've got a tape room coming. Rupper's going to dive into how Michkov can help the Flyers and, you know, what they looked like last year and areas they can improve on. But before we get there, this is huge.
Yeah.
And you heard Briere say we had no idea a year ago that it would be quite this quick. What was your reaction to hearing that?
Well, put it this way. I think a lot of people would share this opinion. If everybody knew that he'd be coming over at 19, he would not have gone seventh overall. You know, the thought process was, and we've seen it in recent history with Kirill Kaprizov, not getting over here till 23, and it was a battle. And jobs were lost during that time of trying to get a guy like Kirill Kaprizov over here. So Danny B and company are thrilled beyond expectation. I mean, this is a kid that theoretically, in some people's minds, could have pushed for that top spot in the draft.
Yeah.
So, you know, having him added to the mix is going to be gigantic, and getting him over here, like Danny Briere said, being able to work with him, see him, develop him from this young age, that is part of the unknown in drafting these young Russian players. And they've got him in their possession here, so I expect them to do big things here in Flyerland.
So when you look at Flyerland and what it looked like last year, where can he fit in? How can he help?
So I want to focus on what they were really good at. Last year, here's some categories that they did well. The shots on goal, they'll throw some rubber on net, right? The rush chances, they were awesome. That to me was something that they did better than most teams in the National Hockey League. You see that as far as being sixth ranked in the rush chances, rebound chances, shot attempts, slot shots, those are all respectable categories. So we're going to focus on that. I want to show just some things. And playing under a John Tortorella, the transition game is going to work for you because you're going to defend. We're going to get a pause here. So anytime you've got a defenseman, this time it's just going to be Zach Werenski. He's making a normal read. But when you don't have any kind of pressure and relief or the defenseman swooping in, keeping his feet going back to his net, these guys, the Philadelphia Flyers, man, they're going north. And they're really hungry to do so. Roll this forward. And they're gonna win puck battles too. They're gonna work hard. Why? They're a John Tortorella-based team. They have to. If they're not, they're not gonna play. And this is what they do. They just get going and off the rush, and they just turn the puck. When they turn a puck over onto the opponent, it ends up in the back of the net real quick. And you're gonna get this look. When there's a ton of ice, don't look for these guys to be swooping underneath. You're not gonna have forwards cutting underneath here to get a 7-foot pass and get going up ice. Heck no. They're going up ice. Everybody's stretching. They're going to make the puck do the work, roll it forward, and they're going to transition game. And they've got players who can make plays. You can catch a pass. Travis Konecny catches it, puts it on the tape, and there you go. Scott Laughton goes down there, and he's another player. He feeds off these types of situations. Another one right here, Adam Fox is going to be caught in the zone. And when you've got a defenseman caught in, they're just going to blow the zone. And that's exactly what they're doing. They're getting going up ice. You're going to have the puck carrier. He's just going to sit here, put the puck to space, lob that thing up ice, get it going up ice, and let our guys win some puck battles, roll it forward. And that's exactly what they do. And Owen Tippett, he might be one of the best off the rush guys in the National Hockey League. Like, this guy loves that open ice. He's got a great shot. Another one right here, Dmitry Orlov, pinching down the wall. When you see a D going the other way against the Philadelphia Flyers, if you're on the Flyers, you see a D going down this way, that's telling me I trust that my guys are going to get it. We're all flying. We're all going. And then we'll roll it forward again here. They generated so much this year off the rush. And that is a strong thing to have, a strong thing to do. Their completion rate on this was incredible as well. But I also think it's due to they didn't generate many other ways. So they needed to have that maybe cheat to go offensively, but there's a trust in there. You can't cheat unless you have trust, if that makes any sense. I'm going to get going to the offense because I trust that you're going to make the play to get me the puck up ice. Mm-hmm. If you turn it over, James, we're in big trouble.
Yeah.
They didn't do that. They did a very good job in that regard.
But they did have some issues, and that was why they ended up failing to make the playoffs. For much of the year, they looked like they could maybe squeak into the playoffs. It ended up being too little, too late. So where do they need to improve?
Yeah, so here's some areas of just generating offense they need to be better at. And the one that I didn't even mention that they're very good at is their shorthanded goals. They led the National Hockey League last year. They're a threat on the PK. But here's the other areas. Expected goals, 21st. You know, the total goals, actual goals, 27th. They just didn't generate enough in other areas of the game. I feel like this is a team that lacked, you can see right there with Ozone possession time, they lacked those long shifts, those grinding shifts in the offensive zone. So that leads us to, how is Michkov going to help out, right? Like, this is a player that, first off, they had the 30-second power play. terrible power play. He's going to help on the power play, and you can see right where he is on that right circle. They need someone over there. They've got some talent, but they need a bigger threat. I think Michkov can be that threat, but he's also a player from, and again, there's not a ton of tape on this guy, just from a lot of different reasons. Yeah. Over the last few years playing in the KHL, but he's a player that there's a lot of Kirill Kaprizov. The stop and go. He's a strong, impactful player. He can play down low. He can create offense. He's a superstar. He's got the ability to be a superstar. And however it plays out, you see him slotted there maybe on that second line. It's going to take a moment, just like it did Connor Bedard breaking into the league. It's going to take a little bit, but we're going to see some stuff. We're going to see him do some things. I'm excited for it. I'm excited to learn more about him. Yeah. But they need a player like this in Philly, and they got him just at the right time.
Yeah.
This is a huge moment for the Flyers.
I mean, just 2 years ago, we were talking about, the Flyers, they really have to go through a rebuild. The rebuild has been accelerated, right? And now they certainly look, on paper, they look like a playoff team. We'll see how it all shapes up, because Michkov has that kind of potential to change this team.